Hello.
You're on my train, I see.
Yes, I've come from Valadilen.
It's been a long time since I've seen a train here. Students, did you bring students with you?
No, I traveled alone. Well, almost alone.
I remember around the start of fall, trains would bring kids from all around the world here to study zoology and botany, paleontology, all that stuff. This was a great university.
And it isn't still great today, then?
Today? Well,
Have you been the station master of Barrockstadt for a long time?
I've never had another job. Now, you tell me, are you in charge of this train?
No, I mean, I'm not sure.
So what's your thing here? You come here to do some bookworming over at the university?
Well, sort of. I'm always looking for new information.
Well, you don't seem to know a lot. And about that train, it's going to get in the way if you leave it there, that's for sure.
In fact, I'm a lawyer, and I'm conducting a pretty unusual investigation.
Investigation, huh? I'm just a station master. I don't know too much about anything.
Well, you never know. Anybody could be significant in this case.
See, nobody actually tells me anything, so my hands are totally clean.
I never implied they weren't. I've just been to see the rectors, and they told me to get the train out of the station as quick as I can.
I thought they'd say that. Rules are rules, and you gotta stick by them. Not a good idea to get into trouble with the university administration.
Absolutely. I've got enough worries as it is. What should I do then?
Well, I suggest you move your train.
But it's like I say, the springs are unwound. Everyone seems to think it's my fault.
The locomotive's engine might not work, it's true, but maybe there's some other way of moving the train.
It's a possibility, I suppose. What were you thinking of exactly?
Nothing. It was just an idea. Anyway, miss, you shouldn't hang around here. I have a job to do. Yes, sirree.
I feel like I've lost my way a little here. I could really do with your help.
Hey, anything I can do, miss, you just let me know.
The name Hans Varlberg doesn't mean anything to you by chance, does it?
Oh, do you really think I'd remember one little name from the thousands that passed through this station?
It seems that your superiors object to the presence of my train in the station. Not exactly easygoing, are they?
It's not that they're difficult to please, but I find that the less I have to do with them, the better things are. Get my drift. Birds, more peaceful than employers. And respect for the regulations. Now that brings peace of mind.
All these birds in a station. It's amazing.
This is no ordinary station, miss. Oh, no. These birds are part of the prestigious University of Barrockstadt Ornithological Collection. Over the years, this aviary has housed some of the most fantastic species from all over the world. And I am not exactly your typical station master, either. This little world is my responsibility, and that is no easy task.
I can well believe you.
And you know what's the hardest? The hardest thing is to keep interspecial harmony. And one day some explorer introduced a couple of cuckoos from the Amazon. Whoa.
It wasn't a good idea?
A nightmare. You know, cuckoos lay their eggs in the nests of other species, right? Now, what's more, they also push the host's eggs out of the nest so that they receive all the mother's attention, right? Accursed cuckoos. Nightmare.
I see what you mean. That's one tricky bird. And there was nothing you could do to stop it?
The faculty declared the bird a protected species. If it wasn't for our mechanical eagle, we were sitting on a major ornithological catastrophe.
You have an automaton here?
A wonder of technology. It's an eagle that's mounted on wheels in the air. It passes through and it swoops down to collect parasite eggs. But heck, the dang eagle's been out of order for several years. Impossible to collect the eggs myself.
Why not?
I can't climb up the gangway. I fell off it several months back, and I still have a pain in my spine. Not to mention the vertigo I've been getting. I only have to look up in the air. Whoa.
You poor soul. That must be very hard.
Worst thing is, cuckoo eggs piling up in the nests. Soon the rectors are gonna notice. There's trouble in store. Big trouble. I'm worried. Yep, worried.
Where might I find some forest Sauvignon plants, please?
No place around here, that's for sure. I don't know what you're talking about. That stuff's from the Amazon.
You know, for someone who knows nothing about the plant, you seem pretty well informed about which mysterious faraway country it comes from.
Oh, Amazon, Peru, Papua, New Guinea, it's all the same to me. Gotta go. Gotta work.
Wait, don't go. You know what? I don't think he was being totally straight with me. Excuse me, Station Master, but I need you again.
Can't you see? I am very, very busy.
No.
Well, I am. Very busy indeed. But, okay. I think I can give you a minute of my time.
I'm looking for a kind of little juicy berry. You don't know where I could find some?
Look, lady, the station doesn't have any Sauvignon berries, not even forest Sauvignon.
Funny you should mention it. That's exactly what I was looking for. Forest Sauvignon.
Sauvignon, raspberries, red currants, they're all the same to me. And we don't grow none of them here.
But you see, I have just read a very interesting book, which says that the rare Sauvignon berry is actually cultivated here, in the famous Barrockstadt University aviary itself.
Well, if it's in a book, then... Don't believe everything you read, miss.
I don't know why, but I don't think you're telling me the truth.
What do you mean? I don't know. How should I know where to find your stupid grave? Go ask your professor, Pons, the paleontologist.
But you're the master of this station, so you should know better than anyone.
Nobody tells me anything. I don't know. Go see the old guy with the fossils.
I won't disturb you any longer, Mr. Station Master.
Welcome to Barrockstadt, miss.